Welcome to this screencast on building QuinType applications with Node.js and React. My name is Tejas, and I'm a developer with QuinType. In this episode, we will show you how to get started with the QuinType Node framework and how to make simple changes and see those changes reflect in your application. Before we get started, here are a few prerequisites. Your development environment should have Node.js, version 8.11 or later, and you should have a fundamental understanding of how React works and how to program with promises. Throughout this screencast, we will be using Visual Studio Code, and if you can install this, it'll be much easier to follow along. Let's get started. The first step is to clone the Malibu repository. Malibu is a starter application, which shows a lot of the QuinType features and is very easy to get started with. This is available at github.com/quintype/malibu. Let's first start by cloning this repository into my local development machine. As soon as Git finishes, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change directory into the new repository, and I'm going to run the run command. This will download all the dependencies required for Malibu and also start the server. This might take a few minutes, so I'm going to fast forward this screencast until this is done. Your app is ready as soon as you see this message, that is, it's listening on port 3000. Let's open this port in Chrome. I'm going to open a new tab and head to localhost 3000. Here's what I see. This is how the default application looks like. It's very simple, but it gives us a foundation to build on. It has a very simple header, which we'll be changing in the next section. It has a section which shows us the latest breaking news, and it also shows you the homepage. The homepage, in turn, is also made up of various sections. In this case, top stories, politics, Travel with Us 2018, and many more. Now that the application is running on our local machine, let's try to make a small change to some component just to make sure that our changes are visible and that we have our development environment set up correctly. In this example, we're going to make a small change to this header component, which I'm circling with the mouse. To do this, let's first open up Visual Studio Code and navigate to the newly cloned repository. You can see the files in this repository on the left. So I have an app folder, which has an isomorphic and a components folder within that. Let's open up the header component. The easiest way to do this is to hit Command P and then type in header/index, which opens up the index.js file in the header directory. You can see that the component is starting on line 10, and you see div style name equals container. This looks very similar to CSS classes, and let's make a small change and see how this reflects. So I'm going to add the class blue. When I save and go back to the browser, you should see that immediately the header's background color has changed to blue. We didn't, in this example, need to reload the browser. It just happened with hot reloading. But where did this class come from? How does this work? Malibu ships with the React CSS modules plugin. When you specify a class using the style name attribute, it looks for the corresponding class in any included CSS. In this case, we have included a file called header.css. Let's open up header.m.css. header.m.css. We'll see that the blue class is defined over here. What happens if we try to use a CSS class that's not defined? For example, I'll just add green and hit save. What you'll see is that your app actually will refuse to compile. So if you look at the error message in the console, it will tell you that you do not have a style name called green. In order to fix this, let's add the class. And save the component as well. Hopefully, your server should have restarted. And your browser will pick up on that and also refresh the tab. You can see this new class has taken effect. On a side note, because this is a CSS component, you'll notice that the final generated class is not the class name by itself. For example, you will see that the blue class corresponds to header-m __blue__some hash value. If you would just like to use regular CSS classes, add it as a class name here. And you will see that this class has been applied at the beginning of this class name. The next thing that we'll try is to make a small change to the home page. To get to the home page, let's first start by opening up pic-component.js. This file is a list of all the pages which are there in your application. We can see that the home page corresponds to the home page component. This component is defined in this file called list.js. You can see that over here, that if the chunk name is list, it opens up list.js. Let's open up component bundle slash list.js, and we'll see that homepage from here comes from a file called components pages home. A quick way to jump to this component is to hover over the homepage and hit command alt down. You can see the homepage component defined here. It has a header which says home and a lazy collection, which is what you see of all the images, as well as a static image all the way at the bottom. And you'll see the properties that the homepage accepts. In this case, it accepts data, which has a collection, which is in turn an object. Let's first change this homepage to say something else. Hello there. Hitting save and going back to my browser will once again immediately change the text in your browser. In the next section, what we're going to do next is we're going to look at how this data appears over here. We know that the homepage expects a data property, which in turn has collection. Let's see how that data gets populated. Let us now try to make some changes to the data that's loaded on the homepage. If you remember from earlier, our homepage is made up of many sections, starting with top stories, followed by politics, and so on and so forth. Where does this come from? If you look at your editor, you'll see a section on the left called Pages. Searching for the home page will show you the collection in our editor which powers this section. You can see on the right that you've sorted the top stories on top, followed by politics, and then Travel With Us 2018. Let's try to make a small change to this. I'm going to move politics right on top and hit the Save and Publish button. Reloading my application should reflect this change with politics right on top. Let's see where this data comes from. All data loading in the Quintype Node framework usually starts with this file, loaddata.js. The main part of this file is this statement, which starts on line 28. And you can see the data that is loaded for different types of pages. In this case, you can see that the homepage data comes from a function called loadHomePageData. Jumping to that function, you'll see that loadHomePageData is pretty small. It imports collection from the Quintype framework server, and it just calls collection.getCollectionBySlug, passing in the client, as well as the collection that it needs to fetch. In this case, home. You will notice that it returns a simple object, with collection having the data that it was required. As you might have guessed, this return value corresponds to the component's data property. So you can see while this accepted collection, that's provided over here. Let's try changing this to something like home 2, which is another collection that we've already created on the editor. Reloading this page, you'll see that the first section has already changed to Travel With Us 2018. If you needed to load some other data, say for example an important story, you would have that option over here. And finally, just to tie this together, let's look at how these routes are matched. In the Quintype framework, this is controlled by a file called routes.js. You can see a bunch of static routes as well as the isomorphic routes. What the isomorphic routes means will be explained in a future chapter. But for now, we can see that the home page is always loaded on the root path. To add a new route over here, you will need to implement load data and pick component for a particular page type, and your new page should be ready to go. We're going to do this in another episode. Thank you for watching this screencast. In this episode, we've covered the basics of installing the Malibu framework and running this on your local development environment. In the next episode, we will cover how to set up your own publisher, how to deploy it to your own environment, and how to customize the components which are shown on your homepage. Please click here for the next episode.